Over a dozen Filipino families in Canada are left without homes this coming Christmas due to an apartment fire in North Vancouver. Rowena Bapasin has this report.
The fire happened at an apartment building on East 12th Street in North Vancouver in the early morning of December 13. North Vancouver School Board Trustee Leilani Tumaneng said almost half of the residents in the 62-unit building are Filipinos. The affected residents were brought to temporary shelters, some to a hotel in North Vancouver and the rest to a UBC dormitory. Many of the victims feel stressed as they lost their homes so close to Christmas.
Wala akong nadala, hindi ako nakapasok kahit nakuha ko lang yung ito, yung bag ko, yung susi ng car ko, tsaka yung phone namin. Pero yung passport itself naming pamilya andun sa isang bag, hindi malocate nung firefighters.
Yung mga gamit namin, hindi pa kami sure kung makukuha namin siya o hindi na kasi building na medyo chemicals na hindi asbestos.
Very overwhelming, stressful, tsaka syempre mahirap maghanap ng bahay ngayon kasi mahal.
When she heard about the fire, Tumaneng immediately posted an appeal on social media for the community to help the affected families.
Ang pouring na support, wala akong masabi. Ang bilis. Kaya kami atang pinakauna dito. Nung 13 ng gabi, nandito na ako. Pero before pa that, may nagpunta na ng lunchtime, nag-deliver ng hot food.
The Tanyada family, who themselves lost a home in a fire when they were still new to Canada, also responded to Tumaneng's appeal.
We used to live in that building in 2017, so we really wanted to help the community, and we feel how devastating the situation is, especially during Christmas time.
It breaks our heart, so kaya kami right away na tumawag, nag-message kagad si Leilani. So right away, we try our best na makatulong kahit maliit na bagay.
Alma Gabriel, another resident at the building, said her employer and co-workers have also been very helpful.
Marami ding tumulong sa aming mga katrabaho, pati rin yung manager namin sa trabaho. They allow us to get some foods in there and clothing as well. And even yung mga co-workers namin, there are times they give us some goods.
But the most pressing concern of victims right now is where they will live. Those evacuated to a hotel were only allowed to stay for 3 days, and those who have not found new lodgings were moved to the UBC where they can stay until January 16.
The next challenge for these families is really finding where they're going to go and live, right? Kasi as I heard, hindi yata na livable yung space or place nila, yung building itself. So that definitely is not safe for them.
Nananawagan po ako doon sa ating mga kababayan na may extra room na pwedeng paupahan sa kanila in a very affordable price naman for now, kasi nahirapan sila kung paano sila makakakuha ng rerentahan nila kasi sa mahal ng presyo ngayon.
Meantime, Tumaneng said those who wish to give food and clothing to these families can reach out to her via Facebook. She said furniture may also be needed once the residents find a new place to live. Rowena Papasin, ABS-CBN News, North Vancouver.
Ukraine's capital targeted by multiple drones in an attack early Monday. Officials in Kyiv say they shot down some 15 Iranian-made drones out of the more than 20 that were detected over the city's airspace. At least two people were injured, with the attack also damaging critical infrastructure in the city. Ukraine's armed forces says other areas in the country were also targeted. The latest Russian attack comes 3 days after Moscow fired dozens of missiles across Ukraine. The assault has triggered widespread power outages and heavily affected Kyiv.